Tom, can you more or less describe how your training went in this pre-Olympic year?
It went excellent, that's to put it short, but I had a good year. Like, I started already last season, you know, to think about it, because I had to realize that last year was not going to be my top year. So then I started to think about the Olympics already last season. And I built it up from, let's say, March and on, and it's been going good all the time.
When did you really start training?
Let's say, if I'm to put a date, March 22nd or so. Right after, I don't remember exactly. There was a record race in here in Vane. Right after that, when I came back home, I said, well, now I start.
How did you do that? All by yourself? Or did you work with schedules of a coach?
I worked with the schedules from our national team coach. Well, I have to do it myself, and I have a lot to say when we plan the training. But I do it. I like to do it together with him because he's a good guy and we work good together. Speak the same language, so to say.
You stayed in Sweden all summer?
Yeah, I was in Sweden all year, except all summer and all fall. And then I went to Insel, and I stayed there for a long time.
What exactly, Tom, did you do in summer? Did you skeeler, or did you go on the bike a lot, or what?
Skeelers I never used. And the bike I use, not a lot, but I do long bike rides, and I do bike sprints, and I do a lot of stuff on the bike. Running I do a lot also, like cross country in the woods, because I like that.
So it's first building up stamina, that you're strong enough, and then go to the ice?
Skating training is a complex program, not a complex program maybe, but you have to work a lot in skating position, and you have to be like a good all-rounder. And I worked a lot on that. I worked a lot on endurance, and I think it pays off now in the season because I feel strong.
But did you totally forget about sprints?
No. I feel that I am fast. But my problem in the sprint was always the technique, because I skated my sprints with a sort of long distance technique. This year it's been going a little bit better. I don't concentrate, I don't train on it, but it just comes automatically.
Are you seeing new things in training, new techniques?
I'm looking at it differently now than I was, let's say, 8 years ago. And it's hard to explain shortly what's the difference, but first and for all, my motivation is for Calgary is so much stronger than I had for Sarajevo. So much more fun this time, because now I'm sort of coming back, trying to beat these new guys. Is the difference in thinking for me is, like when I was 18 years old, 17, 18, I had the Norwegian top skaters. I had some Dutch guys in the top that I had to aim for, that these people I'm gonna beat, you know, Stens and Storholt and these guys. And then Heiden came into the picture. Heiden was, he was a little bit too good for me to go for, but that's what I had to aim for. Then these people quit, you know, and then new people come in, younger people that have to have a different mentality. They go faster, and I all of a sudden I have to realize that, well, I have to set my mind for something else also. I have to go for 6:45 instead of 7 minutes. That was my aim like 8 years ago. And I found that hard for a couple of years to beat the new generation. I mean, I'm talking like an old guy, but that's the way it has been. Now I feel that I'm so much more solid. You know, I feel good. I feel strong, and I'm gonna do what I can to win a medal at the Olympics.
In Sarajevo, you surprised everybody with a brilliant 5 and a brilliant 10, races which were decided in hundreds of seconds. Yeah. Will it be the same now? So close?
I think it will be a very close competition. Well, if we look at the times in Calgary for the 10,000, Kolstad was just too far ahead for us others. But I think at the Olympics it might be different.